Hello everybody, welcome to another Goggles Goes to Europe, and today we're in Andorra and we're heading for Bordeaux in France. And I got my in case you're following all the drama with my stupid design PC or my skinning PC, I got it kind of working now, and I did a couple quick updates on this skin this morning, just a few little things just to show you some progress, and there's still things need to be done. But that little wedge between the rear wheels there, I added a little black into it, put the OS on there, and dulled up the top corners because they were sharp before, and it didn't really suit the lines on the rest of the truck, or got that sort of soft look to them on the corners. So fixed that. Still got a few other things to do. That line, right underneath the old school on the roof, that line where it comes down and goes underneath it, goes right along a seam in the bodywork. That looks kind of bad, so I got to fix that. And I'm still kind of trying to get that line around the fenders just right. I got to spend a little more time on that. And then the front looks all jigsaw-y down the front of that stripe. I got to fix that somehow. So, once all that happens, it'll start to go pretty quick. I've got about 8 or 9 of the 16 skins I think I need pretty close. But anyway, enough of that. Let's hop in and get going. But it's definitely good news that I'm making progress. And with the skinning PC, I still have a lot of personal stuff on there I have to get off, but I've got it back to where I can do skins again. Which is good news. Man, it's been 6 long days of anxiety and stress over it. Pretty heavy load, 54,000. I think I was all set to do an extreme heavy haul with this truck, I'm not sure. And this is the one, I think it might be, or maybe not. I'm trying to think of what engine I have in here, what power rating it's at. I think it's an 805. So I'm not going to have any problem with this load. Sound like I have a voice nav going. First time I've come out of here in this direction. Jeez, I wonder if we gotta go down that real crazy road. Out of here. Yeah, that really cool mirror setup we had in the Scania R from Eugene from Papa Smurf doesn't work in this RJL truck. Or not the same mirror configuration. This is Papa Smurf mirror, but different truck, different mirror. To the right. So it's a SCS trailer that I've just sort of dolled up a little bit. Oh. Oh yeah, we got that crazy road ahead of us. Oh well. Nice if we don't, oh shoot, I was just gonna say, be nice if we don't have any traffic in front of us. And we got this guy. Darn it. That's gonna slow us down. Or we just get bold and do a pass right away. He went straight. Oh boy, all of that drama. Well, that's the end of the real wiggly bit, I hope. That map. I was trying to think of the race course a couple weeks ago in Japan that had the famous S's. It was a Suzuka, of course. I don't know why I couldn't remember that. It must have been on a piece of road like this. I was trying to think of it. Couldn't come up with it. Chance to let the dogs out here for a little while before we have to slow down again. Windsock on the bridge, that's interesting. Must be a real prevailing wind from that direction that can get strong. Happens out here every year. A lot of places around North America, I'm sure. Where semis get blown over on the road. High wind situations. Thank you. Camper. Oh boy. Yeah, I'm experimenting still with those retro developments, 24/5 wheel pack on here. Not super crazy about these ones, but I thought I'd just give it a try for a video. I think they're called Kenworth Twist, if I'm not mistaken. For a little bit here just to make up for that winding road. I don't know if the when they calculate the time en route, if they just estimate the whole thing based on the speed limit of the roads along the way, and well, should take you this long to get there, not considering that that road was, there's no way we were going to hit the speed limit on it, that winding road. It's kind of why I wanted to pass that guy so badly. It's just to not get stuck behind somebody doing a fraction of the speed limit. What's going on up here on the map? Oh, straight through. Gotta get around this guy so we can let the cars go behind us. Hit the guardrail. Looks like another check thingy. Got to yield to who here? Are we going for the same piece of tarmac? No. Is that guy waiting for me or not? I think he is. £54,000 of soy milk. Sorry, dude. Try this view. See who we can scare from up here. Oh, there he goes. So, well, you can look around from up here. You don't want to really do it on a corner. Ah, this road is nothing but corners. So just jump back inside and spare the civilian population. Excessive laundry bill. Oh boy. Yeah, really starting to wonder when 147 beta is going to come out. Sort of interesting to see the ownable fuel tankers and whatever else you have in store. Oh boy, there's a lot of traffic up ahead here. What's going on with all of these guys? Nice area here with all the forest and stuff. Oh, we gotta get in that right lane. We're going to see a bunch of vineyards out here. We're going to Lisette Logistics, which I guess is just going to be a, we'll be in the city at a shipping yard kind of thingy. Bayonne. So this engine, I like the drake brake on this thing so much that it's kind of mellow how it comes, how it comes in, and I'm just leaving it on. I'm not cycling it. It's nice, like I said before, that it doesn't come in instantly when you let off the throttle, so you can just leave it on and modulate what's coming on with the a teeny little press of the throttle. And is very gentle. That one again. Another food tanker. See how cool his looks. Well, that's pretty nice. I looked at this route up ahead and I thought, wow, we're going to be able to really go on this road. 70. I was going 90. Now it's 90. And I'm going 70. Oh, man. Going to have a little lane narrowing thing there. Did we go through here before? Am I going in circles? Did I just go in a big circle? I did. Well, what did I... It's got me going in a loop. Oh, I was supposed to go there. Was the job right there. Oh, my word. Yeah, deja vu, all over again, Koyohibera. Well, we're the load is semi-urgent, I think, but we haven't got the hurry up, so. Soon I'll be hiding my own Easter eggs. All right, let's look for this right-hand turn up here. Probably went by it right when I was talking about it. Oh man, the irony. Probably a great big sign on the side of the road here. Yep, right there. Well, there we go. Little dance around the mulberry bush that we got here. Okay, let's go down the left side here. Remember, this truck has a nose on it. And there we are, we eventually got here. Turn off and unload. See how we did here. We're on time. Used a lot of fuel, wow. We went 536 kilometers on a 500 or 480 trip because I can't see things when I need to. But I'm not 100% sold on these wheels. I like those other ones better. I had on the R Scania, that Night Moves work in progress thingy. And they're sort of okay, but yeah, they look a little bit like a toy. But, yeah, anyway, coming along, you know, I'm like a week behind now and everything. Not that I wasn't 2 or 3 weeks behind before, but we'll get there. So, like I say, got about 9 trucks almost ready to go of the 16, so we're getting there. Take care, guys. We'll catch you on the next one, and bye for now.